Actually, it's very easy to justify that. German armies failed against England. Their piano industry triumphed completely and wiped out the English industry. And all serious English musicians used German pianos. They were just the standard for England. Blüthner in particular had a long-term dealership there that dated back to the late 19th century. And in fact, this one was sold as a second-hand piano by the Grofrin Steinweg dealership on Wigmore Street. Now, Wigmore Street is where Wigmore Hall is now. It used to be Beckstein Hall. It was also where Hamburg Steinways and Grofrin Steinwegs were sold, too, on that street. And there were a few other makes, Ebach, and so much for the English and German pianos. In the case of the French, Blüthner was sort of an adopted German piano for the French. Debussy's personal grand piano was a Blüthner. Fauré's preferred piano was Erard, but when he was playing in Germany, he couldn't get Erard's, and so his preferred German piano was Blüthner. And Francis Poulenc also used them. Years ago, when somebody was trying to describe to me what Blüthners were all about, he said, well, a Blüthner is a German piano that sounds sort of like a Frenchman. So anyway, so that is how we can come up with a justification for using it on a program of English and French music. One has to remember that in the past, the notion of definitive, historically correct performances just wasn't there, and people did things with all sorts of things. So, without further ado, we'll have the real music.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.